What's happening, my fellow reef builders? I'm Jake Adams, coming back at you with another vlog from the Reef Builders Studio in progress. And I think the last time I left you, I was just about to finish this system, and it's getting really close, but we have another video topic today because I received my first real exciting fish. And I don't know if I should tell you what it is or we should just open up the box, because man, it's a really exciting fish. And we're gonna pop it in there in the first token nano tank of Reef Builders. I just turned the light on, so these guys aren't quite opened up yet. But man, this tank is looking really good. Once the corals open up, it's just really, really good. So with that said, we are going to go ahead and unbox this fish right there over underneath my livestock unboxing light. And we are going to find out together what it is. So let's go ahead and do that. Oh boy, this is my first unboxing here at the studio. And I knew I wanted a special fish, but I never ever imagined that it would be something this cool. This fish is from TSM Corals. It hit me up with a picture of it and asked me if they knew someone who would be interested in it. And I said, me. All right, you ready for this? That's a big bag for a tiny fish. Can you see it in there? No, I don't think so. I don't think you can see it in there. Let's see what we can do. There we go. He's a small one. Oh, wait, come on, buddy, don't be shy. There you are. There you are. Like I said, I saw pictures of it and I've seen pictures of fish like it before, but I had no idea that this guy was so big and beautiful and colorful. All right, so let's go ahead and get him out of the bag so we can all get a better, closer look at him. All right, gonna go ahead and let this guy out into the little container so we can get a better look at him. Oh boy, he is well packed. All right, buddy, here we go into your little acclimation station. Gotta be real gentle. Real gentle like. There you go. We got plenty of water. And there you are. Oh my goodness, he's so pretty. So pretty. Look at him right there at the surface. And wow, look at that. So if you couldn't tell, that is actually an aberrant diadema dottyback. Very cool. I've literally never seen one. So normally this fish is just yellow with a purple top, but this specimen from the Philippines, collected by RVS Fish World and shipped to me after quarantining by TSM Corals, is the first one I've ever seen. And it's so much prettier than I could have ever imagined. Man, these little Pictochromis dottybacks are so underrated, and see an aberrant one like this is way, way cool. Hey, buddy. Wow, dude, that fish is crazy. So beautiful. Look at you. Look at that. Look at that hotness. Hey, buddy. Hey, buddy. I don't even know what to say. I knew this fish was gonna be beautiful. I knew it was gonna be pink and yellow, but I didn't really expect it to be so brilliant and have kind of bluish eyes and funky stuff going on in his fins. I'm just like really floored by this fish. But the only catch now is I made such a big deal about setting up this coral tank here without cycling it, because corals don't really care about ammonia and nitrite. Now I'm about to add a fish, which means I have to cycle it. But thankfully, this is not my first tank ever. So I'm just gonna go ahead and pull out this Brightwell BioCube ceramic porous thingy that I've had in one of my other reef tanks for a year. I gave it a good rinse, and I think one of these should be enough to support the biload from one small fish. And here we go, this is how you instant cycle. All right, just gonna pop open that back filter, take the bio block, and drop it in. instant biological filter. So yeah, there it is, that's all. This tank is now ready for fish. But I'm not gonna take for granted that it's cycled because I put a piece of biomedia in there. I will absolutely feed very lightly here for the next little while. And I will get an ammo alert from one of my local fish stores just to keep an eye on any potential ammonia levels. But man, what a really, really cool fish. I'm gonna go ahead and acclimate him. And the one really important thing I need to do before I walk away from this tank with this very special fish in it is I've got to cover this tank. I don't know why it comes with this lid, this giant open area back here, but anyway, I am going to DIY some simple, workable little filler for that. So I'm gonna go ahead and put together that little lid, acclimate this fish, stick it in there, and hopefully he's not too shy that we can get a good look at him. So I put the dotty back in here just about 10 minutes ago, and this little aberrant diadema dotty back is just real calm, cautiously curious about what's in the tank and outside the tank. And this guy's really big and just really bright purple, bright yellow, and kind of like deep lilac blue eyes that, you know, probably doesn't really show in pictures quite as much, but I cannot think of a better fish to really kind of kickstart the Reef Builder Studio. I feel a little bit sheepish for how much production and pomp I put into putting together a tank that isn't cycled for corals, and ended up with a really cool fish that I have to put in here and cycle the tank for. I'll probably make it to the fish store in a couple days, get an ammo alert, and man, I just want to definitely give a little round of applause for RVS Fish World for collecting just yet another sensational, really cool fish. The diadema dottyback is normally all yellow, which is kind of a purple cap on the top of the body, and this guy is like just really, really brilliant and big and beautiful. And I got to give props and very big thanks to TSM Corals, link in the description below. They're the ones who got this fish. I went very ghetto on covering this back part with straight up packing tape, but it is tight. I'm only gonna use that for a couple days until I find some materials. But man, in the meantime, I'm just, again, really tickled to have a really cool fish. And now that I have some corals in the studio, and some fish in the studio, you know, I could say I have a saltwater community tank. So maybe next I'll put in some snails and stuff. But in the meantime, it's time to wrap up this video. I got a Shaky Graves concert to go to at Red Rocks tonight. Shout out to all the Shaky Graves fans out there. And man, thanks everybody for tuning in. I'm gonna have another video out very soon. So if you're subscribed, make sure to hit that notification bell, because those videos are coming in unpredictably fast. So until next time, I will catch you guys on the next episode.